Welcome to Just Jesus. One life to live, one life to give. Hello, friends. My name is Pastor Brian Park. I want to welcome you to another episode of Listen Up, where we listen to the heart of God through the Word of God. We're studying the very basic foundational teachings about Christianity, titled Christianity 101. Today is Lesson 14, Jesus' Identity, Part 4. Stay tuned. We've begun a very important series on studying about Jesus Christ. And today, in Lesson 14, we'll continue to study about Jesus' identity, Part 4. God urges us to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, 2 Peter 3:18 and Ephesians 4:13. It's very important for Christians to grow and mature in the knowledge of Jesus Christ and unity in absolute faith in Jesus to build up the body of Christ called the church. Merely attending a church or having certain titles in the church does not automatically elevate you as Christian. If one calls oneself as a Christian, then one must know who Jesus is, grow in the knowledge of knowing who he is, what he taught, and how we live out his teachings. Then, who is Jesus and what is his identity? Jesus alone is the only one who is 100% God and 100% human. Yes, friends, Jesus is the only one who is fully God and fully human. And let's examine why this is so important in our salvation through the Word of God. Once again, there are many Bible verses I'll share with you today, and I urge you to write them down, study them, inscribe them in the tablet of your heart, and make them yours by living it. First, Jesus is 100% God. Because knowing Jesus as God is so important in our faith, we're purposely taking time to study the Bible to learn about these indisputable facts and make them the fabric of our lives. Though it may be slow going in studying this, once these are inscribed in the tablet of your heart, then you can trust Jesus and start living for Jesus. Since Jesus is fully God, he has a full measure of divine attributes. We already studied this. First, Jesus who is God is omnipotent. Second, Jesus who is God is omniscient. Third, Jesus who is God is omnipresent. Fourth, Jesus who is God is eternal. Five, Jesus who is God is immutable. Since Jesus is fully God, he not only has, but is all this and so much more. And because Jesus is God, he is absolutely trustworthy. Yes, absolutely trustworthy. How is this possible? Because God cannot lie. We humans try not to lie, but God cannot lie, for it is contrary to his nature. Numbers 23:19, God is not human that he should lie, not a human being that he should change his mind. Does he speak, then not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? Titus 1:2, God who does not lie. Yes, this God, Jesus, who does not lie, testifies about himself, along with Father God. John 8:18, I am one who testifies for myself. My other witness is the Father who sent me. Then what does Jesus testify about himself? Jesus clearly testifies that he is God by declaring, I am, 7 times, as recorded in the book of John. John 6:35, then Jesus declared, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. John 8:12, when Jesus spoke again to the people, he says, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life. John 10:9, I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. John 10:11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. John 11:25, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. John 14:6, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. John 15:5, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you'll bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. I am, I am, I am, I am, I am, I am, I am. Why is Jesus declaring I am 7 times so important? Why is it so important? We've already covered this in Listen Up episode 13 when we studied about the divine name Jehovah. Exodus 3:13-15, Moses said to God, suppose I go to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? Then what shall I tell them? God said to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you will say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. God also said to Moses, say to the Israelites, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever, the name you shall call me from generation to generation. Here, God tells Moses his divine name is, I am who I am. Then, what is God's name that we shall know and remember and call from generation to generation? We already covered this. In theological term, it's called tetragrammaton, meaning 4 consonant letters, Y, H, W, H. In Hebrew, it's Yod, He, Vav, He. Because these 4 consonant letters are impossible to pronounce, practicing Jews do not speak aloud or read aloud these letters, for it is forbidden. But they replace it with different terminologies. They pronounce God's name as Adonai, meaning my Lord, or Elohim, meaning God, or Hashem, meaning the name. But for non-Jewish people, it's often anglicized to pronounce as either Jehovah or Yahweh. Therefore, Exodus 3:14 is translated in King James Version as, I am that I am. In NIV, it's translated as, I am who I am. But in NIV, there's a footnote saying, I will be what I will be. To this translation, if you were to add Hebraic grammatical tense, God's divine name and nature are revealed like this. I am who I am. I was who I was. And I will be who I will be. To these unique divine attributes, if you were to add action verbs, then God's divine name and nature are revealed to us like this. I do what I do by my own my power. I did what I did in the past by my almighty power. And I will do what I will do in the future by my almighty power. Here. God introduces himself as I am, and any Jewish person and any serious students of the Bible would easily recognize this phrase, I am, as God referring to himself. When Jesus used this phrase, I am, 7 times, as recorded in the book of John, he was in fact declaring that he is indeed God. Yes, yes, yes. During Jesus' public ministry, he clearly declared that he is God by referring to himself as I am. Now, do you understand why Jews so desperately wanted to kill Jesus? John 5:18, for this reason, they try all the more to kill him. Not only was he breaking the Sabbath, but he was even calling God his own Father, making himself equal to God. The reason Jesus was able to call God his own Father was because he is not only equal to God, but he himself is also God. One of the members of the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. That's why Jews wanted to kill Jesus so desperately. But friends, we're not quite done yet. Bible declares that Jesus walked on water. John 6:16-21. When evening came, his disciples went down to the lake, where they got into the boat and set off across the lake for Capernaum. By now it was dark and Jesus had not yet joined them. A strong wind was blowing and the waters grew rough. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus approaching the boat, walking on the water. And they were frightened. But he said to them, "It is I, don't be afraid." When they were willing to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the shore where they were heading. Here in John 6:20 is translated in English as, "It is I, don't be afraid." But in original Greek text, Jesus says, "It is I am, don't be afraid." In Greek text, Jesus says, "Ego eimi," meaning "I am." Friends, Jesus didn't just say, "It is I," but he clearly said, "It is I am, don't be afraid." Therefore, if you were to expand what Jesus said, it would be something like this, a little bit expansion version. Guys, it is I am. And I am God who's with you. And because I am God, you must not be afraid. Because I am God, I walked on water. And because I am God Almighty, you must not be afraid. For I am bigger and more powerful than all the world and everything in it. Wow. How wonderfully assuring and comforting is that? Jesus is saying to us, even now, that because he is God and because he's in control of everything, we must not be afraid, for he's bigger than all the realities we're facing now and forever. This same event is also recorded in Matthew 14:27 and Mark 6:50. But in all these verses, they're translated in English as, "It is I," but now we know that in Greek text, Jesus says, "It is I am." By declaring that he is I am, Jesus is actually referring to the Old Testament promises also. Isaiah 41:10, "For do not fear, for I am with you. Or do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Joshua 1:9, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." Amen, amen. Now, what do you do with this newly discovered truth? Philippians 4:6 and 7, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus." Hebrews 13, 5 and 6 and 8, "God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. For we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me?" Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And to on top of all this, Jesus already told us in John 16:33, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." And this same Jesus is inviting us. Matthew 11:28, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Jesus, who is God, can transcend time and space to know all my troubles from my past to my present and even to my future. And with his infinite power, can accurately custom make solutions to help me overcome any and all troubles now and forevermore. For he is all-knowing and all-powerful God. Therefore, without any shred of doubts, you can trust Jesus and run to him for all your troubles, for he will help you completely. Then, how can I run to Jesus for help? Something we already shared, but I want to repeat to you once again. G-A-G, G-A-G, G. Give all your burdens to Jesus, Matthew 11:28. A, ask Jesus for help, John 14:13 and 14. G, give thanks to God in advance for hearing your prayer, Ephesians 5:20. Once again, I want to share with you a simple yet just very powerful sample prayer. Lord Jesus, I give my such-such pain and sickness to you. Lord Jesus, I give you my such-such problems to you. Help me, Jesus. Thank you for hearing my prayer, and thank you in advance for what you're about to do. But even if you don't help me, I still choose to thank you and trust you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Lastly, please practice this 5-second rule. Whenever you're sick or in trouble, pray this simple prayer 5 times. It only takes 5 seconds. Help me, Jesus. 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 You can pray these simple prayers for Jesus, omnipresent God, and with this omnipotent power can easily help you overcome all your troubles whenever you run to Him with your faith. Then once again, who is this God? Just Jesus, of course. Hence, the name of our channel is Just Jesus. Friends, there are even more Bible verses clearly declaring that Jesus indeed is good God. And we can and must trust Jesus, for His goodness and greatness is beyond all our collective knowledge. But in order for you to enjoy all His goodness and greatness, you must first give your life to Jesus. Absolutely trust Jesus, follow Jesus, and remain in Jesus for all your days. Please remember these simple things. You do your part and He'll do His part. You do your best and He'll do the rest. Once again, you do your part and He'll do His part. You do your best and He will do the rest. Not that you had a chance to hear God speaking from His heart into your heart. You have a choice to make. Accept His invitation to trust Jesus or reject Jesus. Pray you'll make the right decision and enjoy His goodness now and forevermore. Please remember this simple formula. Just Jesus, surrender plus repentance equals restoration. Pray you open your heart, give your life to Jesus, and begin to live for Jesus and enjoy all the blessings in the conditional use privilege by giving God a chance to prove to you how wonderful He is. Jesus is waiting for you. Friends, will you just open your heart? Will you just trust Jesus? Thank you for listening to the Heart of God, and I would love to lead you to a simple prayer. Would you mind repeating after me? Precious Father, I'm just so grateful beyond word. I know You are good, but I never knew You were this good. Lord, please forgive me for not trusting You. Please forgive me for not running to You for all my troubles. Now that I heard from Your heart into my heart, I make a firm commitment to trust Jesus, follow Jesus, and remain in Jesus for all the days of my life. Thank You for this amazing privilege to be able to call You Father, to live for You. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Listen Up is found on Just Jesus channel on YouTube. And I want to invite you to grow together as we listen to the Heart of God through the Word of God. Friends, we love you and we'll see you next time. God bless you.
The sun, and I'm your sunflower.